When I first came up with the idea of a poet populist, some of my colleagues on the Seattle City Council, they supported it, but they were taking a deep breath and wondering how this was going to work out.
When I first heard about the poet populist program, I was very excited about it because Tara Hardy was the poet populist at that time, and I found out that people had gotten involved and voted for a poet and that she was going to be representing poetry in the city. I thought that was really important because there's a lot of places where people are afraid of poetry.
But since I chaired the Arts Committee, I got them first introduced to the idea by actually having each of my committee meetings begin with a poetry reading by a poet that we would invite in. We would call it Wordsworth. And since I've been on the council now 10 years, we've had about 150 poets that have read in City Hall. And since our council meetings are taped, those poetry readings are actually in the web.
One of the issues with the program is whether or not art can be legislated. Can you vote for art? And I don't think that the program is intending to say one way or the other on that. It's, you know, it's a very Socratic dialogue. We don't know. But the thing is that people need to, the more people get involved, the better we'll have an answer to that question. Same question for legislation. Can legislation be creative? Can politicians speak creatively? Can poets speak representatively? Can they represent people? Or is it supposed to be this, you know, artist out on their own in an ivory tower, in a garret somewhere, creating, you know, the higher meaning?
When we put the poems that are read at my committee meeting on my website, we checked to see how my website was doing in general. And we found that the hits were way out of scale with the other council members' websites. And we had a debate in my office as to why that was. And we had the hits analyzed further, and we discovered that there were more people visiting my website to read poetry than there were people visiting the city's budget website to find out how their public dollars were being spent. And I found that very insightful as to where people's values are.
When a state or a country has a poet laureate, it's usually through a peer panel process where a number of recognized poets are nominated, and then a group of poets gets together, or people who are experienced in the literary arts get together, and they choose who they feel should be the poet laureate. What I like about the popular vote is that it says that we can all have an opinion about what it is we enjoy. We can all have an opinion about the particular poets that speak to us or speak with their language to our hearts.
If the art is supposed to speak to everybody and yet everybody can't participate in it, then there's a major gap happening. So who gives people privilege? How do they make their decisions? Ultimately, it has to come from the populace. And if that populace is cut off, then the logical extension of that argument is that the artist will not be able to speak to anybody except for other artists, which is exactly the opposite intention of this program, which wants the artist to speak to everybody.
Obviously, I consider public libraries not just the heart of the community, but the most populist institution, people-oriented, non-judgmental institution in our world and in our community of Seattle. So it seemed perfect for that. Plus, the whole concept of poet populist had personal resonance because as a child, I somehow didn't think I was smart enough to read poetry, just like I knew I couldn't sing or dance. That wasn't about smart, it was about coordination and quality. And I, you know, and so that's been an insecurity in my life. And I thought, how incredible if something like this had existed when I was a kid, so I wouldn't think you had to be really, really smart. And I wouldn't have this insecurity as an adult.
So since being elected poet populist, I'm trying to think how my work has changed, if at all. I'm not sure that it has, other than I have this idea that there are going to be more venues now, to not so much to read my own work, but to really to draw attention to especially the young kids that I work with. I do a couple of different residencies for the Writers in the Schools program. And if I can sort of redirect some of the attention that might come to me through this post to them, that would be terrific.
I've always been fascinated by the relationship between civic engagement and poetry or the literary arts. When I was active in college a number of years ago, I had the opportunity to listen to the poet Allen Ginsberg, and it was in a very large cathedral-like structure. And I was amazed that there were literally thousands of people that turned out to listen to a poet. And this was a poet who was, you know, a bit chubby, wild black hair, big beard. And he had great poetry, but also what really struck me was how he brought together people and how people linked to each other through the ideas that were expressed through poems that he was reading. And from that day onward, I kept thinking, you know, poetry is a very powerful tool. It should be part of our civic life.